Today I'm gonna share with you a recipe that I borrowed from one of my best friends, Sherry McDermott, Pizzelle cookies. I love Pizzelles. They're light, they're crispy, and you could eat tons of them. And the recipe that she gave me makes 12 dozen, which is quite a bit. So I cut it in half, and she got this recipe from her mother, Judy Luceni, grew up right next door to them. And I just love Pizzelles. They're really easy to make, and you can make so many of them, and they really last for quite a while, a few weeks, if you keep them in an airtight container. You just have to be careful what time of year you make them, because the humidity is a Pizzelle killer. And the traditional ones are made with the anise oil, which are my favorites, but a lot of people don't like anise, like my mother, Jelaine, not a fan. So you can also use vanilla flavoring or lemon extract. A lot of people like the rum. There's a lot of different flavors, chocolate, but I'm going with traditional old school anise. For this recipe, you'll need 6 eggs at room temperature. You'll need flavoring, either 1 tablespoon of anise oil or 1 teaspoon of pure vanilla extract or 1 teaspoon of lemon extract. 1/4 cup of canola or vegetable oil, 1/4 cup of Crisco, 1/4 cup of oleo or margarine, 2 to 2.5 cups of sifted flour, 2 teaspoons of baking powder, 1/8 teaspoon of salt, and 1.5 cups of sugar. Now remember, before you make these cookies, you need to have a Pizzelle iron. Ruley Brothers has a great selection. I am warming this one up. I don't like the ones with the Teflon coating because I don't think the cookies are as crispy, but that is your personal preference. They're about $40 to $50. And I've melted down the Crisco and the margarine before I add that to the eggs. So this is just cooling to room temperature. All right, so we have the 6 eggs right here in the larger bowl. And we're gonna start by mixing these until they're frothy. 3 to 5 minutes with the mixer on medium. All right, so we'll get started with the eggs. All right, so see, a lot of air has been whipped into the eggs. They're nice and frothy, and that's what we want because we want a nice, light, crispy cookie. So now, to the eggs, we are going to add our margarine and canola oil, or you could use vegetable oil, and then our Crisco. All right, and it's been tempered nice, so we'll add this. And this is also when we add our anise oil. Now, they do have the anise extract, but they have these little bottles. They sell them 2 at a time at Ruley Brothers in the spice section. And I bought these, and these are the equivalent, as you'll see when I take the lids off. And I love the smell of anise. I just love anise. 2 of these little bottles are 1 tablespoon. 1 and 2. And that's exactly what we're going to need for these cookies. So we'll add this, and now I'll add the sugar. All right, and we'll beat that for a few minutes more. All right, slippery dishes, trying to get them out of the way. All right. All right, so now you see the batter is nice and creamy, and we'll no longer need the hand mixer. So now I'm gonna take the dry ingredients. That'll be our sifted flour. Make sure you sift it, very important. The baking powder and the salt. And I'll just mix this together just a little bit to combine those. And then we'll just add this right to the batter. And we'll finish this off by hand. We'll just get the spatula and mix this together until we get it mixed thoroughly and together, and we have a nice smooth Pizzelle batter. All right, so we have a beautiful smooth fragrant butter, and I'll cover this with some plastic wrap and put it in the fridge. You want to chill it for a few hours or even overnight, and then we'll be ready with the pizzelle iron. All right, so this is a little trial and error when you are making your pizzelles. Because remember, you've got to use a little bit of oil or spray, and you want a nice lubricated iron, but you don't want too much. And it's almost like pancakes. The first couple plan on ruining, because you got to regulate the heat and checking all that in your quantity. So we've been playing around with this. I think milk and coffee are the best things to drink with pizzelles, but Jelaine thinks, and I think you're right, while you're making them, you better have a glass of wine. And so I really appreciate you helping me with this, Mommy. Cheers. Here we go.
Casey, I remember making these a few years ago with the old-fashioned one.
Oh, boy. The stovetop.
Yes, my friend Ann Clement had, it's probably really an antique now.
Now, I used, don't mean to interrupt, about a half of one of these larger soup spoons for each well. And then you have to get a little watch with a second hand. And I am going 25 seconds on these. Now, a lot of people say 20 seconds, but I like a little bit of brown to them, like a light tan. So let's see how we did. Oh, those look good. Now, just take your fork. They're gonna be very, very pliable when you first take them out. Ooh, these kind of stuck together. And then you just put them on your cooling rack. Already crispy, look. And they're perfect. Remember, store them in an airtight container. All my neighbors used to keep their coffee cans. And you don't want them to break because they are very, very fragile, but they are crispy and they stay for a good 2 weeks.
As long, in the summertime, it's very,
very iffy. Hard. You know, you gotta watch your humidity. Mm-hmm. But I'm telling you, just go to my website, CaseyMaloneShow.com. The recipe's there for pizzelles. Love them. Cheers, Jelaine.
Cheers.
Here's to you.
Here's
Thank
to
you,
us.
Sherry. Thank you, Judy.